People of God, I'm speaking to you all. Anyone sitting behind that setup? Yeah, please come. I'm going to read from Psalm 100, but I'm going to read it in Message version. Is that okay? So I think it's going to be there on the screen too. This is what it says, Psalm 100. Can we all read it together? Okay. You have your phones or your Bibles with you. Message version, Psalm 100. Let's read. It says, on your feet now, applaud God. Bring a gift of laughter. Sing yourselves into His presence. Know this, God is God and God, God. He made us, we didn't make Him. We are His people, His well-tended sheep. Enter with the password. What is that password? Thank you. Make yourselves at home. Do you feel at home? Yeah, you should. Make yourselves at home by talking praises, thanking Him and worship Him. For God is sheer beauty, all generous in love, loyal and always, ever and ever. Can we all just rise up to our feet this evening and just begin to worship Him and thank Him for who He is in our midst? Who He is in our midst. Can we just lift up our voices? Enter into His presence with thanksgiving. Oh, we bless your name. Jesus, we bless your name. And our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, some power and love. Our God is an awesome. Can you all lift our voices and sing it out together? Our God. Come on, you sing it. Yeah. hearts, Lord, this evening. Be glorified and be lifted high, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This evening, I have a very, very dear friend of mine, Pastor Stephen Peters, all the way from LA. And he's someone, when you see him worship, you would know that he doesn't sing for people, but he sings to God. And at that moment, God comes down and touches people. Amen. He's a businessman. He designs parts for German supercars. And he's very, very talented. And so he'll share a lot of things as he continues to sing. So would you put your hands together and welcome Pastor Stephen in our midst.
Thank you for joining me today. This place plays a very special role. And before we even get started with worship, 2016, I came here towards the end of my music career, and I witnessed what took place at NLAG, and it impacted me in such a deep way that I took some of the things I learned from here and I took them back to LA. And then my wife and I started a house church, and Pastor Chadwick kind of became a mentor to us. And so many beautiful things from this church has now helped shape some things in Los Angeles. And I can't get into all the things that have happened, but for me, this journey, the last, 6 years of my life, I owe to the experience here that changed me. It was being here. And so it's really a privilege and an honor to be back with all of you. Some of you may have been here when I came the first time. So thank you for coming tonight. Thank you for coming tonight. Before we even get started, Abhishek, if you don't mind, can I have a little bit more guitar in the ears? Great. Can we sing this just the voices before we even get into this? Yeah. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be silent. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. And I would love, can we have not even the band, just the voices carry that. It's the voices. So I'm going to stop for a second and let you sing it, right? There's joy. There's joy in the house. Oh, we won't be quiet. Let's raise it up, sing it. There's joy in the house. Quiet. Louder. There's joy in the house of the Lord. We won't be quiet.
There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house. won't be quiet. Shout out and praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. Shout out your praise.
Forgiven, redeemed by His grace.
Let the house of the Lord sing praise. Just the congregation sing. Ready? There's joy in the house. Quiet, we shout out your praise. Amen. something with you, and it's just something I sense from the Lord, and the band is not going to like me for this. So let me share something with you quick before I even sing the song. You know, for the better part of 20 years, my life has revolved around doing worship in churches and traveling and touring. And a few days ago, we came into a worship seminar here. And a lot of the teaching was on the origins of worship. Just it actually has almost nothing to do with music. Most of it has to do with giving to the Lord, living a daily sacrifice. And so I was talking to Pastor Shalom when we were like, let's do this worship night. And we're like, hey, I have this idea. Let's we'll start on stage and we'll move over there. And as we got up here and we're just playing, I'm just like, in my spirit, I'm like, man, something is off. We're back to stage again. And so I'm going to ask, can we just move? Let's just move. And I'm going to ask you as a congregation, just bear with me, okay? You guys can start heading over there. It's good, yeah. What I would ask you to do is this. You see how all the chairs are facing the band? Can we just move them? And I'm going to ask, let's make a circle. If you need to sit, you can sit, but we're gonna like make a circle there. And let me explain why. Was it yesterday? We did the training? It was yesterday. I was talking about how when we do worship songs as a team, you guys can, yeah, see all these chairs right here? Let's move them. Let's turn, flip them around. Flip them around. Oh, sorry. Flip them around. You guys can make space on here. Don't worry, we'll fix the chairs later. I know, lots of clunky noises, and that's okay. That's okay. You didn't know you were going to get into a little workout before coming to worship today, did you? Thank you. Thank you for doing that. So let me talk a little bit about what we did yesterday. When you study worship in the Old Testament, it's the act of laying like down on your belly before the Lord. The Levites before a battle would come out and sing worship to set the tone for the battle. Joshua sang and walls were broken. David sang and demons fled. Paul and Silas were in prison. When they sang, what happened? Chains were broken. And there's this correlation between what happens in the spirit also happens in the natural. And the reality is this, like, and I'm sorry, team, thank you for being flexible. It's not that I'm anti-stage. It's just, we've turned worship into that. And as we were singing, I was just like, in my spirit, I'm like, this is not right. And so yesterday when we were doing this worship thing, I had the musicians kind of break into groups around this room and just picked a key and said, hey guys, just start worshiping and singing and whatever you feel the Lord has led you to sing. And so for, I don't know, maybe an hour, people were just singing. And actually, it was one of the most powerful moments of worship I've ever felt in this room. I just sat here while the tech team and media team and worship team, they were just moving around, and they were all singing different songs to the Lord, listening. Some of them had a scripture, a verse, some of them had some, and they just started singing. And I just started crying. I'm like, oh God, your presence in here, Lord. And so for tonight, we do what we normally do. We make a set list and the team has lyrics. And I just feel like the Spirit's saying to me, we need to wait. And so tonight, I really feel like what we're gonna do is we're just gonna sing and we're gonna see how the Spirit leads. And maybe someone in this room has a song, maybe someone has a lyric, a piece of scripture they're gonna say out loud and we're gonna sing it. But this is not a worship concert. It shouldn't even be a thing. This is a body coming to sing to the Lord, amen? Is that okay? So maybe let's this, me and you, okay? Band, if you don't mind on me, I'll start with them and then we can jump in. As the Spirit was moving over the water, as the Spirit was moving, and as you sing it, declare it, call down the words that you're singing. As the Spirit is moving over the water, come rest on us. We're singing that for this church, we're singing it for you. So as we sing this, declare it over yourself. As the Spirit was moving, as the Spirit was moving, if you feel led, rise and declare. Spirit was moving over the waters. move, you make my heart pound. When you fill the room, you're here and I know you are moving. I'm here and I know you will fill me. Come down, Spirit, when you move, you make my heart pound. When you fill the room, you're here and I know you are moving. I'm here and I know you will fill me. Come do it again. But what I'm going to ask is, if you don't mind, would you stand with me? And we're going to take this posture. We're going to declare it. The Levites, right before battle, they would go out and they would set the tone. King Jehoshaphat, when he was down, he felt like he had to get the Levites out, blow the trumpets to stop something in the spirit from happening. And so I'm going to ask, band, we'll keep it chill, and let's just see who here will start singing Fire and Wind. Come do it again. I don't care if you're on key or off key, but this is a song of the people. It's not enough to play karaoke at church and just sing these lyrics day in, day out. We have to mean what we say. Are we asking God to be fire and wind? Come do it again in this place. Is that what we're asking for? Are we asking? So then I'm going to ask this. You don't need a worship leader. You don't need a band. Congregation, would you, someone here will do it. I'll just start playing and someone's going to shout it. And this is what I'm going to ask you. If that's you who wants to start this part of the song, I don't care if you're on key or off key, shout it out as a declaration over this land. Fire and wind, come do it again. And let's just go with it. So we're just going to hang out here until someone in their spirit feels like, Lord, lead.
He said, on you I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail. Fire and wind, come do it again. Open up the gates, let heaven on in.
That exist in India and around the world that are against the kingdom of God hate this moment. They hate when God's people get together not to be entertained but to sing as worship, as warfare, and to break the bonds of the enemy. And friends, what you're doing here in this moment is not just singing with me. We are pushing back the gates of hell. In the spirit, we're pushing them back out of Chennai, out of India. We're pushing them back in other nations. They hate it, and let them hate it. In heaven, we see that there's a lyric that's sung. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Why that's so powerful? Because in scripture you'll see this. When God created the heavens and the earth, he called it holy. And something we must learn is only God can make things holy. Humans can't. And so this beautiful word that we throw around left and right, heaven declares a king holy. So would you sing this with me?
Holy, holy, worthy is thank you. of it all. You were worthy of it all. For from you are all things, to you are all things. You deserve the glory. You are worthy of it all. Worship is like incense for a king. Day and night. Mighty. You are worthy.
There's one song ever since I started playing guitar and singing that has always affected me so deeply, and I have to hesitate before I sing it. The song is Surrender. And if you don't mind, can we pull the lyrics up? I want to read them to you. And Ben, if you don't mind, I'll just take this with the community. Let's do a guitar and the community. You remember when I told you in the Old Testament, the act of worship is like laying down, right, on your face? In the New Testament, Paul says worship is offering your body as a daily sacrifice. And today, worship is a band making a bunch of noise. But it is the act of surrender to a king, asking the Holy Spirit to guide your life. And so there's a song, and I've always struggled to sing it because I have to mean it if I sing it. I don't think the Lord really cares if we're, I use this phrase like singing karaoke or just following the lyrics on a Sunday, and there's no conviction of what the lyrics mean. Dare I say it's dishonest? And so I'm going to read these lyrics to you, and actually I'm going to ask this of you, if it's okay. If you don't mean what the lyrics are saying, don't sing it. That may actually be more honest to the Lord, and he can handle it. He's okay if you don't mean it in the moment. Every time I sing it, I have to think about it. I'm looking at the lyrics right now. I remember on my wedding day, my wife and I sat up in the chapel and we sang these lyrics because I wanted to start my marriage with these lyrics. So I'll read them to you. I'm giving you my heart and all that is within. I lay it all down for the sake of you, my king. I'm giving you my dreams. I'm laying down my rights. I'm giving up my pride for the promise of new life. And I surrender all to you. All to you. I'm singing you this song. I'm waiting at the cross. And all the world holds dear, I count it all as loss. For the sake of knowing you, the glory of your name, to know the lasting joy, and even sharing in your pain. And I surrender all to you. All to you. In the church world, when we sing songs, we're used to doing this, right? This is like our posture, hands raised, or maybe heads bowed, or whatever it might be. We do different things. How about when you pray, you close your eyes? Where did you learn that from? These are isms that we do. They're symbols of what we're trying to do. And so I'm going to ask this of you as a family, only if you're willing. What if we took a different posture when we sang this song? What if we kneeled to represent what we're saying? I surrender to you. And if you're a person who's like, hey, Stephen, those lyrics are really hard to sing, that's okay. Don't feel pressure. I'm with you. When I sing it, it's hard. Am I meaning what I'm saying? And I'm going to leave some space to you to find your own posture of surrender. Maybe it's not kneeling. Maybe it's putting your hands out and saying, Father, I surrender. Maybe it's laying on the floor. I don't know what it is. But I would ask that we would be honest as we sing this song. And that goes for the worship team too.
giving you my heart and all that is within. I lay it all down for the sake of you, my King. I'm giving you my dreams. I'm laying down my rights. I'm giving up my pride for the promise of new. And I surrender all to you, all to you. And I singing you this song. I'm waiting at the cross, and all the world holds dear. I count it all as loss for the sake of knowing you, the glory of your name, to know the lasting joy, even sharing in your. And I surrender all to you. And I surrender all to you. All to you. We surrender.
Declaring things that we surrender and confessing it, in fact, publicly. And so to take us a step further and push you ever so gently a little further out of your comfort zone, may I ask this? Would you be willing right now to call out and say it, declare it, Father, I surrender blank, whatever that might be. If you feel comfortable, would you do it? Just shout it out. I'll start. Father, I surrender my life, obviously. But there are still things in my heart. There are certain wants. There's dreams, desires. And it's okay to have them. But Father, I say this to you now. I surrender to you. Not my will, but your will be done over my life. Whatever that might be. You have been so good to me. You have been so good to me when I have not been good to you. And I happily give you this life. Use it as you see fit. However this soul and this flesh can be used by you until my last day, it is yours. And do as you will. Help it to be a weapon and a tool for the kingdom of God. I give it to you, Lord. I give you my marriage. I give you my resources. What rights do I have? No rights. I give you the rights I think I have. I'll leave space as you wish. Call it out. See in the spirit as you're confessing these things, chains are being removed over people. Things are being loosed. There's things the enemy has wanted to keep in you for many years, and one by one I'm watching them in the spirit be loosed. Thank you, Lord. I'm not going to rush this time because there's more that still needs to be undone. Use it. Release. curses are being broken right now. I can see it. Anxiety is lifting. Depression is lifting. Lies that the enemy has whispered is lifting. It's lifting. Break the curse, Holy Spirit. Break the curse in the name of Yeshua. I ask that you undo the lies of the enemy. I take the authority in your name, Father, and I ask for healing to come upon this land. I ask that every lie whispered, every curse placed on an individual here be undone in the name of Yeshua. Father, I ask that every whisper, the identities that have been spoken that are false, be broken in the name of Yeshua. Every sickness be undone in the name of Yeshua. That you would raise an army of a people of faith and launch them to the ends of the earth. Father, I pray especially to this. There's been a curse over India of a mindset of poverty and not of people who are kings and queens in a kingdom, a royal priesthood. And so I speak to this. Would you shift the mindset in this land? Shift that principality of oppression, of not being good enough, and you would restore them and say, I am a son and a daughter of a king. I am a son and a daughter of a king, and I will rule in his kingdom for his purposes. I am surrendered to his kingdom, not my own and not the principalities of this land. I belong to the Lord's kingdom.
I surrender. I surrender, Jesus. I surrender. Stand to our feet and let's throw our hands to the skies and everyone. I want to know you. I want to know. I surrender. I surrender. I want to know you. I want to know you more. Like a rushing wind, Jesus, breathe. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. A song, let it stir. Stir within my soul. Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, have your way. 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 Everyone, declare together, Lord, have your way. Lord, have your way. In us. Surrender. We surrender.
We surrender. Lord.
as a church, we want to know you more. Reveal your heart. Reveal your heart. Help us to get a glimpse of your heart. Touch your heart. Oh, Father, let your heart rub onto us. We want to know you. We want to know you more. We surrender. Shift us, transform us. And this night is a night of transformation, Jesus. This night is a night of shift. Once again, we pray that your fire will continue to refine us. Your fire will continue to refine us and change us, transform us. Lord God, turn us 180 degree, a 360 degree around of us. Some of us, oh Father, need slight shifts. Some of us, oh Father, need major shifts. Certain things, oh Father, in our life needs to be shifted. Certain aspects of our lives need to be shifted. But I pray that this shift will happen, and it's going to happen in our lives. And we receive this shift, oh Father. Would you just clap your hands and glorify the Father and thank God for this shift. Thank God for this transformation. Thank God, oh Father, that our buildings, oh Father, wherever we gather, will always be supercharged with your presence, oh Father. That when we enter in, oh Father, that the presence of the Almighty God will shake the lives of people. Lord, people will be convicted of their sins. I pray, oh Father, in the city of Chennai, Lord God, even as people are walking the streets of Chennai, and I pray, oh Father, as they drive through the streets of Chennai, that there will be a spirit of conviction. Once again, Lord, a revival. Build your church. Build your church. Build it from the ground up. It's your church, Jesus. This is your church. Can we lift our hands and everyone declare, this is your church, Father. This is your church. This is your church. Build it up. Build it up. Build it up. Build it up, Father. Build it up.
I will build my upon your is a sharp foundation. I will put my trust in you, oh Lord, and I will not be
Yours is the glory. Yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus.
What a beautiful.
What a beautiful name it is. The name.
Death could not hold. Everyone together, sing it out.
Death could not hold. When door before you, silence the ghost of sin and grave. Heaven's alone. Praise on your glory.
No rival, you have no equal.
Now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all things. What a powerful, powerful, powerful name, powerful name. Every sickness in the name of Jesus be gone. Every torment of the evil one be gone. Every torment of the evil one. Every frustration in the minds of people. Every bondage, every curse. We curse in the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is.
What a powerful name it is. With every hands lifted up and praying in the name of Jesus, every part of darkness that tries to affect me, I cast it out in the name of Jesus. Every hindrance that does not allow me to progress, I break it down in the name of Jesus. Every form of depression, I cast it out in the name of Jesus. Every form of mental weakness and mental disorders, oh Father, that affects my mind. Every frustration that causes me to be down and under, in the name of Jesus, we rise up. We rise up. We rise up. And we call the name of the Lord. And those who call on the name of the Lord will be saved. Those who call on the name of the Lord will be delivered. I called unto him on the day of my trouble, and he answered me, and he delivered me. And I will glorify his name. Would you lift up your hands and glorify his name in advance for the miraculous things that are happening. This night is a night of miracle. This night is a night of healing. This night is a night of deliverance. Every form of discord inside families, I break it by the power of the living God. Every form of divisions inside families, I cast you out in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh Father, victory. We pray for deliverance. We pray for victory. We pray for deliverance.
all of my life, Lord, glorify thy name. Be thou glorified. Be thou glorified. Be
lift our hands and everyone for the last time sing together.
Be thou glorified. Be thou glorified. In all of our lives, Lord, glorify thy name.
Together, I want you to know that we are part of a worldwide network of beautiful families. And Stephen and Nicole and Colton is here. Colton, would you please come? Stephen also. Nicole, sorry, I'm pulling you in front, Nicole. The way to the front is only through here. Shalom, would you lift up your hands so they know here? Nicole and Colton. Yeah, they're making it. Good. And so we're going to pray for the church in LA. Is that okay? Everyone, can we pray together? Because this church has the potential. One of the deepest desires, I believe, that God has laid in the hearts of Stephen, Nicole, Colton, Jordan. Jordan is today. Jordan and Phoebe are not yet here. They were serving in different places and resting it a bit, but this evening I want you to lift up your hands and pray together. Okay, constantly I spend a lot of time with these guys, so I want you to know that this is not somebody who came from outside to be with us. This is family. This is part of the great family that God is building. And one of the most important things that God is doing is shaking LA for Jesus. Amen. He's shaking LA for Jesus. Not only this church is a house church with around 45-50 people on a regular attendance, but God is shaking the entire city of LA. People are beginning to listen and understand that something different is happening in this place. And what God has laid into Stephen and Nicole's heart is that God would use them in the post-Christian world of North America and the post-Christian world of Europe. And therefore, there are going to be churches in different other cities of North America. We have named 8 other cities in North America where God is going to do something powerful. Or there are going to be cities in Europe that God is going to do something powerful. This church is going to be multiplied into the Orange County. This church is going to be multiplied into different other locations within LA. And so every hand's lifted up and praying together. Some of you need to leave your seats, come forward, lay hands on Stephen and Nicole and begin to pray. Come, don't worry about who you are. Just come from wherever you are. And I want you to lay hands on Stephen, Nicole and Colton and begin to pray. Come boldly. Come, if you're a youngster too, just come forward. Just come, surround them. Yes, come forward and surround them. And let's pray together. Everyone laying your hands on them and everyone just surrounding them and praying together and saying, God, something powerful will begin to happen, oh Father, through Stephen and Nicole's life. I pray that the struggles that they go through as a church will cease, oh Father. Lord, I pray that this church life and leading the church will be one of the most joyful things for them to do.
I pray every frustration of Father that the enemy tries to frustrate, every form of attack of Father that the enemy brings against the church, oh Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we break it. We break, oh Master, there will be a shift. Just like how, oh Father, they are bringing a shift into Chennai, I pray, oh Father, that we from here will shift things in LA, oh Father, in the name of Jesus. Every powers of darkness that stands against the church will not prevail. I pray, oh Father, every open door through which, oh Father, Satan sneaks in to attack this church, oh Father, we shut it closer in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh Father, for a powerful anointing to rise up, because the powerful anointing, oh Father, will break the yoke. It'll break the yoke of United States of America. And I thank you, Lord Jesus. Small little things, oh Father, done consistently, oh Father, will bring great shifts. And you're going to bring that shift. So we bless. Would you lift up your hands and lift up your voices and say, we bless Stephen. We bless Nicole. We bless, oh Father, Colton. We bless, Lord Jesus, Phoebe. We bless Jordan, oh Father, this team that has come. Lord, we bless Max and Yadi, one of the leaders there, oh Father. These core leadership in the church there will be touched and blessed. Be touched and blessed. We bless Remnant in Jesus' name. We bless, oh Father, the churches in the One Church Network. Across one global network across the world. We pray for the churches in Bahrain. We pray for the churches in Dubai. We pray for the churches in Abu Dhabi, oh Father. We pray for the churches in Varanasi, oh Lord God. We thank you and pray for the churches in Vishakhapatnam. We pray for the church in Manipal. We pray for the church in Bangalore. We pray for the churches in Pune, oh Father. We pray for the Marathi churches in Pune. We pray for the churches in Mumbai, Lord Jesus. We thank you for what is happening in Kargo. We thank you for what is happening in Mulwe. Thank you for what is happening in Nerul, oh Father. We pray, oh Father, that there is a powerful anointing that will flow. We thank you, Father, for the churches that are happening in Delhi, in Jesus' name. Thank you for the open doors in Kolkata, in Jesus' name. Thank you for the church in Vancouver, Lord God. Thank you for the start of the church in Atlanta. Thank you for the church in, Lord Jesus, I pray, in Houston. And thank you for the church in New York, Lord Jesus. Thank you for the churches that are going to be started out in Nashville once again, in the name of Jesus. Do powerful things. We humble ourselves and we say, why have you chosen us? Who are we that you are mindful of us? What do we have? Nothing. For we are dust. And we go back to dust. But Lord, dust in your hands is powerful. Because you can blow into the nostrils of this dust your power. And that makes the difference. And we receive your spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Just give the Lord a big hand of praise and thank God. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. You didn't come to watch a person, and that's what this night was. This night was, you didn't come to watch some musicians. They had turned their backs towards you. I mean, that's the part. Like, they're not even showing their face. They turned their backs towards you. But we are all showing our faces to the one who deserves all praise, glory, honor. Amen. Amen. And so have a fantastic week. How many of you would love to gather together in times of worship like this? We it doesn't matter if, would you still come if we don't advertise? Or is it like something we need to advertise and say, so and so is coming and so come? Or would you come because, hey, Jesus is here, can we come together for worship? Is that okay? Where we are able to lift up our voices and say, hey, Jesus, I'm going to announce the next time, Jesus is here, come worship. Is that okay? And you all will come from all the six centers across the city, and we're going to worship Jesus.
And we're going to have a time of worship. Now and then, we're going to refresh. We're going to say, God, you are going to give us a powerful breakthrough every now and then. And we know that worship is just not singing, right? It's not just music and worship. We know that worship is a wide range of things that we do. But this is one of the small little forms of worship that we do enjoy. And it's been traditionally practiced over several years. But we do enjoy coming together and singing songs together. God bless you guys. Good night. You want to say something, Stephen?
Yeah, actually one thing. So in one of the things that really stood out from my experience here at NLAG a few years ago, I saw what the Spirit of God was doing here. Pastor Chadwick invested in us. And when I came back to LA, I said this: no website, no social media. Is the gospel enough? And so to this day, our church has no website. There's no advertising, there's no social media, none of it. But to Pastor Chadwick's point, what we did is we just said, come gather. And somehow, some way, people would find out, would show up, and it would attract a very different type of person with a high level of grit who is willing to come pray, intercede. So I love that. You don't need advertisements or names or this person or that person. Is the gospel enough? And I can tell you, as a person who tried this as an experiment in Los Angeles, a city of everything is entertainment, I can tell you that coming in the opposite spirit drew a very different, beautiful crowd of people. So would you do that here? Amen. Amen. Fly, be free.